Hello, hello, good afternoon. Oh, good morning. I don't know in what moment are you seeing this video, but I hope that you are very, very, very happy. So today we're going to see music and society. It is very important that you put so much attention. This is the page 128, unit 12. This is a very easy work, I think so. So we're going to start immediately. We're going to start immediately. What song have changed the world? Okay, so that they have an impact and the people beliefs change. I don't know if that's possible. What do you think? Just listen to a podcast about music and society. Note down one reason why each song's below influential was influential. This is very important. Belief, this is from Cher in 1998. And do they know it's Christmas Band Aid 1984? It could be great if you have the opportunity to go to YouTube and listen them complete.
Audio 12.6.
Right, so in today's episode, I'm going to talk about two songs that have had a sizable impact on the music industry, and in some cases, on the world at large. Let me tell you a little bit about each one. The first song was written to raise money for anti-famine efforts in Ethiopia, and it was once the UK's best-selling single. I'm talking about Do They Know It's Christmas, performed by a charity group called Band Aid, whose lineup included some of the biggest British and Irish musical acts at the time, including Bono, Phil Collins, and Sting, among dozens of other pop stars. The other song I picked for today's episode might come as a bit of a surprise, but it was a tremendously influential song, and an irresistibly catchy one at that. I'm talking about Cher's comeback single, Believe, which topped the charts in dozens of countries when it was released and went on to sell 10 million copies worldwide. Believe was a calculated effort. When the producers walked into the studio, their goal was to make a catchy dance tune that would appeal to both Cher's older fan base and to club kids, some of whom had never even heard of her. So, they had an idea. Why not take her vocals and tweak them with AutoTune, an audio processor that changes people's voices and, in some cases, makes them unrecognizable? To everyone's surprise, Cher didn't refuse to be auto-tuned, and the song instantly caught on. Now, why was each song so influential? Believe was such a monster hit that the auto-tune effect soon spread like wildfire across the music business, especially in R&B and dance music. Today, auto-tune, also known as the Cher effect, has become ubiquitous in the industry, and you'd be hard-pressed to find a singer who doesn't use it, at least sparingly, to correct a few imperfections here and there. Which I think is fine, really. It's as if a song were wearing makeup to look prettier. What bothers and worries me is that, in my opinion, today most people, regardless of talent, can take a shot at singing if they can fall back on auto-tune. It makes you wonder if singers are just one step away from being completely replaced by robots or soulless zombies that are detached from their art. Now, moving on to the Band-Aid song. Do They Know wasn't a tune I instantly warmed up to, and I remember being underwhelmed when I first heard it. But the song eventually grew on me, maybe because of the message it was trying to get across, and the amount of money it went on to raise, of course. What's remarkable about Do They Know is that it showed artists their influence could be used to bring about real change. And this eventually inspired other fundraising anthems such as We Are the World and That's What Friends Are For, just to name a few. The song really raised awareness of issues such as famine and hunger. Nevertheless, The biggest charity rock songs ever recorded date back to the 80s and 90s, which makes you wonder if pop and rock artists may have given up trying to make the world a better place. And if so, why?
Okay, I'm sorry, but my little dog is here. You know, we are working at home. She's crying and crying. So now we are going to continue. That's so interesting, no? Sometimes we never think about how important is music, but it is. Okay, now we want to check the next part. You say listen again and check. So you're going to put a check here. The points the music critic makes. Okay, most singers use autotune these days, which is objectionable. Autotune has made singers less unique. Autotune is los que te mejoran la voz o que tienen echoes or something like that. Okay, fundraising songs should be as catchy as possible. Okay. Music may have lost some of its impetus for social change. Well, so we're going to check which of these are named.
Audio 12.6.
Right, so in today's episode, I'm going to talk about two songs that have had a sizable impact on the music industry, and in some cases, on the world at large. Let me tell you a little bit about each one. The first song was written to raise money for anti-famine efforts in Ethiopia, and it was once the UK's best-selling single. I'm talking about Do They Know It's Christmas, performed by a charity group called Band Aid, whose lineup included some of the biggest British and Irish musical acts at the time, including Bono, Phil Collins, and Sting, among dozens of other pop stars. The other song I picked for today's episode might come as a bit of a surprise, but it was a tremendously influential song, and an irresistibly catchy one at that. I'm talking about Cher's comeback single, Believe, which topped the charts in dozens of countries when it was released and went on to sell 10 million copies worldwide. Believe was a calculated effort. When the producers walked into the studio, their goal was to make a catchy dance tune that would appeal to both Cher's older fan base and to club kids, some of whom had never even heard of her. So, they had an idea. Why not take her vocals and tweak them with autotune, an audio processor that changes people's voices and, in some cases, makes them unrecognizable? To everyone's surprise, Cher didn't refuse to be autotuned, and the song instantly caught on. Now, why was each song so influential? Believe was such a monster hit that the auto-tune effect soon spread like wildfire across the music business, especially in R&B and dance music. Today, auto-tune, also known as the Cher effect, has become ubiquitous in the industry, and you'd be hard-pressed to find a singer who doesn't use it, at least sparingly, to correct a few imperfections here and there. Which I think is fine, really. It's as if a song were wearing makeup to look prettier. What bothers and worries me is that, in my opinion, today most people, regardless of talent, can take a shot at singing if they can fall back on autotune. It makes you wonder if singers are just one step away from being completely replaced by robots or soulless zombies that are detached from their art. Now, moving on to the Band-Aid song. Do They Know wasn't a tune I instantly warmed up to, and I remember being underwhelmed when I first heard it. But the song eventually grew on me, maybe because of the message it was trying to get across, and the amount of money it went on to raise, of course. What's remarkable about Do They Know is that it showed artists their influence could be used to bring about real change. And this eventually inspired other fundraising anthems such as We Are the World and That's What Friends Are For, just to name a few. The song really raised awareness of issues such as famine and hunger. Nevertheless, the biggest charity rock songs ever recorded date back to the 80s and 90s, which makes you wonder if pop and rock artists may have given up trying to make the world a better place. And if so, why?
Okay, so I hope that you have your answers and we are going to continue. So I'm going to give you now the answers according to these two. Okay, so we are going to check the answers of these ones. Only number two and number four were named. Excellent. Now we are going to the next part. This time you are going to complete 1 to 5 from the highlighted of these words. You have the meaning already here. Mm-hmm. Phrasal verse. Listen to check. Bring about, make something happen, catch on, become popular, fall back on, use as a last resort, como el último recurso, okay, get across, make an idea clear, convincing, grow on, become more appealing over time, so va creciendo tu popularidad, por así decirlo, o tu influencia, warm up to, begin to like something or someone, okay? So please complete it, stop the video. I have the time that you already, and then I'm going to read this first and later we are going to check the answers. Transitive and intransitive phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs can be transitive or intransitive. What is it, teacher? Okay. Intransitive phrasal verbs don't take an object. Why did Ava break up? Vamos a leer el transitive so it is more clear. Transitive ones need an object. Many are separable. For example, they called the concert off. The object is the concert. Remember, the object es aquel que recibe la acción del verbo, mm-hmm, o del subject. Or we can put call off together. And también se pueden separar o no. So, for example, they call off the concert. En ambos casos, the object is the concert. In the first part, okay, no estamos utilizando un object. El subject no está haciendo ninguna acción sobre un object. Did you see? Okay, number three. Others are inseparable, including most three-word phrasal verbs. O sea, hay phrasal verbs que no solamente son de dos, sino de tres. For example, can we go over the contract once more. Nunca se puede poner go the contract over. I'm looking forward to their next release. Estos no se pueden. Son expressions y como tales las tenemos que aprender. Okay, a rule doesn't exist for real. Solamente es seguirlos leyendo, seguir haciéndolos nuestros. That's why it is important to do this kind of activities, okay? I'm going to give you now the answers. I ask you as a favor, léanlos por lo menos unas 2-3 veces in high voice para que los vaya recordando también su oído. Well, so I'm going to give you the answers of this section. I'm going to put it bigger so you can see. Excellent. Well, now to say here. Write 1 to 3 next to the phrasal verbs in C. So we have 1, 2, and 3. And in the letter C, so this one, you are going to put a cual de estos tres pertenece. Try to do it. It's not easy, okay? But maybe you can check. And in a minute, I tell you. Stop the video. And the time passed by, and the time passed by. Okay, now I'm going to give you the answers. And here you are. This belongs to each of the rules. So these are completely the number three, get across, can be separable or not, catch on, it's only two, but these are the answers. Okay, we are going to remember, so okay, others are inseparable, yes, like these ones, los que nunca se separan. Intransitives no necesitan un object, porque no a quién aplicar, el subject no le aplica a nada en realidad, pero están los transitives que sí están, por así decirlo, transmitiendo, por decir una forma, la acción del subject a un object. Okay. Well, I hope that you don't have questions. As I told you, this is like kind of a very easy activity. See you next time. Bye.